first time I worked with someone with a disability who wasn't a family member, I just felt like there was more that could be done. I really got to see some high-end technology and get another perspective on the kinds of technology that someone would use to really have full independence on a computer and things like that.
I have worked for the past 30 years as a speech-language pathologist in a public school system. Instead of me being the one who's asking the questions, I have people calling me to ask me some questions, and all the way from administrators to parents to other professionals in the field, because they recognize that I am now an expert in assistive technology.
One of the things that I really valued about this program is that it is a program that encourages the participants to look outside the comfort zone. Don't treat each individual with a need as a subject. Think of an individual with a need as a challenge to assess, determine, and apply the appropriate solutions to meet their needs and mitigate their inconveniences.
Learning on the engineering side of the whole, you know, of assistive technology and the medical side and, you know, the service side, you know, what people are, what they're looking for out there that I didn't know was out there. I just thought it was more, you know, how are you going to play on that computer and make it work for somebody. It's more than just computers. It's mobility device, it's a speech device, it's assessment, it's helping people in all aspects of life and aging.
In addition, one of the other features about this program that makes it very unique and special is the cohort. Being able to go through the two-year course curriculum with the same group of people, you create a bond between your fellow classmates. You learn who can help you with what kinds of things.
It also allowed us to basically collaborate with each other on how to deal with compound disabilities, which is something that you don't see in other programs. For me in particular, visual impairment is something that I live with, something that I deal with, and I know how to assess, determine, and apply solutions. But now I have to think in terms of what else could be wrong that may inhibit this person's ability to learn. And talking to people who work with others with cognitive disorders is a major plus.
What I started here is continuing. That's actually pretty exciting, is actually being able to put it to work in the real world.
So all in all, I think the hardest part sometimes was trying to get 40 hours of work in and 40 hours of book study in 1 week. But I'm here, I did it. If I can do it, you can do it too.